Skyrim Let's Play video. For this Let's Play, I will be running the Nolvus Ascension pack, which contains just a little bit over 2,000 mods. The game Skyrim is pretty much remastered, and I haven't been playing this game in forever, so I thought it would be pretty cool to check it out and also make some ASMR for you guys. I am playing as a Nord, which I actually named Karl. And right now we've just crossed over from Bruma, because this mod pack contains the Beyond Skyrim mod, so you can actually go to Bruma as well. Perhaps we should have started there, but I decided to start in Skyrim instead. For this Let's Play, I sort of wanted to roleplay a bit as well. So Karl is a Nord, but he doesn't really know any magic. So as you can see, he basically have no magic spells at all. And I don't really think I want to learn any magic as well. But maybe that will change. But in any rate, there is also a religion mod in this game, or in this mod pack, I should say. And so, Karl is a firm believer in Mara, so he's a follower of Mara, and that means that we can also bless a home, but we can also pray, and if we pray once a day, we can strengthen the bond with Mara, and I'm not sure what that means right now, but I'm sure it will be something we'll do, or at least try to do once a day to see how we can benefit from being a follower of Mara. Other than that, you know, I started off with the an axe and some clothing, and we'll see where we'll go. I'm not really sure, you know, where I want to go with this Let's Play, but I think I at least want to finish the main story. Maybe the DLCs as well, just, you know, to make some proper content for you guys. And if you should happen to fall asleep during the video, then, you know, that's a win-win, right? Because, you know, I get to play Skyrim again, and you get to watch it and maybe fall asleep, and perhaps be entertained as well, but not too entertained, because I really want you guys to fall asleep first and foremost. But yeah, let's head on into it. And I really think that, you know, Karl, being burly and, you know, pretty large, he's a big fellow, but I really think of him as, you know, a pretty friendly guy. So there's also a mod in this mod pack that sort of enables a unique form of trading, where the prices of some items sort of, they change depending on which region you're in. So for example, if you're in a region where there is a lot of ore, maybe gold and you know, jewelry, then you can buy that pretty cheap there. And then if you travel somewhere else where perhaps jewelry is you know, pretty sought after, then you can sell it and make a lot of profits. And so I sort of think that's something that Karl would, you know, do. Maybe you'd like to make an honest living and sort of trade in Skyrim. But for that, we need to find, you know, a settlement, a city perhaps. So we'll do that. And I'm pretty excited for this let's play because I haven't played Skyrim in so long, you know, so just rediscovering this bit. Oh, what happened here?
Get out of here.
Oh, this door. Oh, what? What the hell? Oh, wow, it does a lot of damage. Horse either. Or do I? It's a beautiful horse, but well, I mean, Karl wouldn't know this guy to be a bandit, right? That makes no sense. So he's just a dead body. Nah, we're not gonna steal the horse. But then again, if we leave the horse here, you know, you'll die. Or she. You know what, I'm gonna take with me. At least until, you know, we find your owner. That's something. Let's go. It's pretty great to already have a horse this early on, to be honest, but I don't think we can keep it. We'll have to return it at some point to someone, I guess, or perhaps just return it to a stable or something where someone can care for her. What's this settlement? I think these are more bandits, right? Well, I think we're gonna stay clear. I don't think Karl is strong enough to actually do anything right now. Seeing as he only has clothes and that one guy actually severely destroyed us. And one thing that I can already tell you is that how much beautiful this game looks compared to for when I last played it, you know. For example, oh wait, how do I get off the horse? How do I dismount it? That's not it. stop doing that. Like this. Yeah, there we go. Okay. I do remember these from the Elder Scrolls Online. It's a sky shard. But in the Elder Scrolls Online, you sort of get a skill point. So I'm not sure what this will do, but... wait, what? Oh no. All right, the horse goes back to the owner. Yeah, that makes sense. Well, thank you for the ride, horsey. You take care. Let's see here. So this would be Helgen. And you know, of course, little do we know that there has been a dragon attack here. But of course, Karl wouldn't know anything about, you know, it being a dragon attack. For all he knows, this is just, you know, part of the Skyrim civil war. You know, perhaps the Stormcloaks attacked, or perhaps the Imperials attacked or something, and left the entire village in disarray and destruction. There are no bodies, which, you know, I guess is sort of weird. But for old time's sake, I'm gonna go through the fortress. Can I do that? Can I enter over here? I usually go the Imperial Road, so let's go into the Helgen Keep through the door. Oh, let's see here. Oh, it's so weird with not Hadwar being here. also Skyrim mixed unit. Oh, isn't this a skill book? Nope, I guess not. Let's see here. Let's search the entire chest. I'm gonna take that one. That's cool. Yeah, let's take that. Steel quarterstaff. That's pretty valuable, so let's take that. I'm not gonna bother with the Imperial armor, though. I don't want people to, you know, think that I'm a legionnaire or something. Iron sword. No. Let's see. Yeah, this brings me back. What would you have? Another iron axe and hide boots. Well, I guess I need the boots better than you, man. Sorry. What about that quarterstaff, though? That's a two-hander, I'm guessing. Oh, they added animations as well. Oh, and a stance. Let's see here. Okay. What about this stance? Oh, holy Jesus. Okay, yeah, I like it. Let's go with the quarterstaff. Let's see here. Oh, that's some cabbage. I think the mod actually comes with a sort of survival mod as well, called Sunhelm, which sort of adds the need for sleep and drinking and eating, as well as, you know, warm clothing and the like. So, and that's sort of like if we don't eat or drink, it will actually affect our stamina and vitality and magicka. So we're gonna take all the food we can find. All right. Let's see here. Karl is one hungry boy. He likes to eat. What's this? Quality potion of resist poison. Okay. Weak potion of magicka. And weak potion of health. And what do we have here? Another quarterstaff. Let's ignore that. Honey. From magicka. Yeah, let's take that. Why not? Village red wine. Yeah, let's grab that. I'm not sure if Karl actually likes to drink wine. I'd figure him more like an ale person or a mead person, seeing as he's a Nord. I do remember that you shouldn't always go for this barrel though. Yep, a lot of potions. And I think salt is pretty important as well. For cooking. Let's see here. I'm almost nostalgic running through this place again. I almost want, you know, to do the original introduction. Where you get to follow either Hadvar or Raylov. Oh, a shield, I'll grab that. I think they have changed the appearance of the maces and the weapons as well, right? Because I don't really remember them looking like that. Let's see. Lockpick. Anything else? No. And Book of the Dragonborn. You know, I always liked that they put the Book of the Dragonborn this close, this early in the game. It's like a foretelling, you know. But I don't think I've actually read this book, so maybe I should do that sometime. I'm not gonna do it now, but we'll take the book. Now this guy, let's give lockpicking a go. Oh, no, no. I'm gonna break it. Oh, no, perhaps. No. There we go. Yes. I'm gonna take it and perhaps that one as well to sell it. And the potions for selling. I always thought that, you know, the novice robes actually looked so cool. Should we take the hood? Yeah. I'm not gonna take the clothes though. No, we gotta be mindful of the dead, respectful of the dead. So, let's continue. Thank you for the septum, Mr. Skeleton. Let's continue down through these caves. It is so weird. Now when there are no people attacking me here, it actually feels kind of good. But hopefully it's not too dark for you guys to see, so you can see what's going on. I remember that you can sort of, isn't there like a fire bowl or something down here? No, I remember you're able to set this on fire, I think. So you can sort of burn the Stormcloak rebels or Imperial soldiers when you pass through here. Which I thought was so super cool. Right now, here comes the cave part. I remember there being, you know, a bear and some spiders. And some coin purse. But this is new, I think. Are these some boots? Rusted boots? He's like the Oblivion Guard. I think it is, right? Like the Imperial Guards in Oblivion. Is it? Wow, that's actually pretty cool. I guess that's part of a mod pack. That's actually super cool. Well. Oh, right, here comes those. Oh, wait. Are those scamps? That's actually new as well. I'm gonna save here. I don't wanna die again. What stance do we do? Do we do the bear stance? Yeah, let's do that. Oh, let's go. Oh, that poison is fine. Escape tunnel. Wow, look at that. Yeah, it doesn't. Wow. It's almost like an entirely different game. I chose to install this with the Rudy EMB. I know a lot of people like the Poochie. I think it's called the Poochie EMB preset. But, you know, I always like the Rudy EMB. So, and look at the, listen to the sounds. That's wow. I really do like this mod pack. This is super cool, guys. Let's see. Well, you know, Karl has already proven to be quite the fighter with this quarterstaff, but yeah, I know. A quarter. just, you know, perhaps it's not very warrior-like, but I'd like to think that Karl is just, you know, he's just trying to be a nice guy. He's just a nice fellow, so maybe he's having a quarterstaff because it, you know, he doesn't really want to be too aggressive, you know, like he doesn't want to use a claymore or a battle axe or a warhammer. He just wants to use a quarterstaff, so, you know, maybe he can sort of defend himself, but without really hurting anyone too much, you know. At least, you know, that's how I want to see him. You know, he's an old man. Well, he's graying, at least. I think he has a graying beard. And let's see if we can remove the... let's equip that. Oh, wow, that also looks pretty cool. Okay, well, we're a wanderer now. But let's, if we remove that, you know, you can see it sort of has graying hair. So, I guess he should have more wrinkles than he has, though, I guess. But, you know, we're gonna get the traveler's one. And these, maybe. Oh, right, they added a couple of pouches to the belt. That's also super cool. Well, we're almost looking like, you know, Aragorn or something, I'm not sure. let's go. And this should be the way to Riverwood. But, you know, I don't recognize this at all. You know, the forest is so good. It's like, you know, it's really like a different game. The Nolvus Ascension Mod Pack sort of, you know, it remasters it. It overhauls everything, which is so cool. Let's see here. There should be the standing stones down here, right? Unless they change that. Oh, I'm getting a little bit of lags when I equip the the traveler's magehood, but it looks so cool. I want to keep it. But let's see if we can, you know, maybe go without it for a while. Yeah, that's already better. Let's see here. I used to always go with the warrior stone, you know. Oh, what's that? Amulet of the warrior. All combat skills increase 10% faster. That's... yes, please. But the thing is, so Karl doesn't really know magic, so I, you know, getting the mage stone would be... well, we're gonna take the amulet. Doesn't really make much sense, and I don't really want to be a thief character or, you know, an assassin or anything, because that sort of feels out of place. I'm gonna take the amulet though. But so I guess we're going the warrior stone again until we find something better. So yes, receive the warrior stone. I already have the blessing of the stones. Well, okay, apparently. But let's equip that amulet. 10% faster, that's actually super great. And let's get that one as well. Because it seems to be pretty cold outside. And let's go to Riverwood. Oh, I hear wolves. Wait, is this the way to the mine, right? I think it is. Let's not go there right now. Let's see what... oh, there we go. Oh, what? That's a new wolf. I haven't seen that before. Is that a new model? Well, I'm gonna save, Scam. Auto save for the win. Let's see here. Okay. that one's huge. Oh, Alpha Wolf. Well, not so alpha now, are you? Would you like to start Hunterborn now? Yes, I guess. Please wait a few seconds for Hunterborn to start, then activate this carcass again to continue. Right, so Hunterborn is sort of like a hunting overhaul mod. So it sort of makes the hunting experience a little bit better. But let's see here if we can't. Oh, it seems like I can loot it without the mod. Okay, well, let's do it the next time. But yeah, I'm absolutely changing the difficulty settings, because right now I am just like this quarterstaff. It's almost too powerful. Karl has become, you know, that's some Yetli shit. That's some crazy, yeah, Bruce Lee style, you know. Don't really wanna be too over, you know, too powerful, too overpowered, you know, at level one. All right, got some frame drops, and wow, they have actually. The river wound a little bit more since the last time I saw this. It's you know, these houses are pretty new. I don't recognize these. Oh, and that's not the sky shard over there. Let's go grab that. I want the sky shard. Let's go. Sure, which one of the sky shards that was, but let's just continue. Riverwood discovered. Okay, cool. Oh wow, look at that! Look at the armor. He actually looks really cool. Oh, is that a short sword as well? Sorry for staring at you, my dude. Well, let's continue. Okay. Let's see here. I'm not sure what we should do first. Well, I guess we should go to the trader. You know what? Let's actually go to the inn. And you know, judging by the sign, the Sleeping Giant's Inn. This, I guess, is the inn. Well, Carl would assume this is the inn at least. So. have deserved sleep here. And we're gonna sleep for a couple of hours, I think. And once we've done that, I'll see you guys in the next episode.
This is an ode to Skyrim's staunch protector.
Sleep tight.